We are here to do what? To worship. Leadership, leading by seven. Are you interested in the people that the Lord has assigned you? Said, is it not just only one? Even if it is just the congregation you have is your wife only one. Minister to her. It is you and your children. Minister, you can't fail. Don't think about failure. Don't even consider it. I have a father who has never failed before. When he calls, he back up. Only if he did not call. But the morning he called, he said, those he has called, he has glorified. This is a sign that God called him. He has proved it over and over and over and over again. So if he has called you, whatever be the ministry, whether you have an independent ministry, you know, because I came to say and I discovered that many people think the only ministry that exists is church. No. If you look at our bulletin, it is there. There are fivefold ministry. Some he has called to be apostles. Some he has called to be prophets. Some he has called to be pastors. Some teachers. Some evangelists. And that's the aspect I want to take this morning. I want us to open a Bible. I'll be talking about effective independent ministry in Europe. Effective independent ministry in Europe. I'll be talking about it briefly. I think in the next few minutes I should be done. Acts chapter 10, verse 38. Heavenly Father, we bless you this morning. As we go into this short seminar, Lord, speak to us. Father, I yield myself to you, that Lord, you will speak to me and speak through me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
So effective independent ministry in you. How do we run it effectively? How do we do it? And is this scriptural? So I'm going to start from the scripture. Acts chapter 10, verse 38. Acts 10, 38. He says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about. Where was he going? Going about. He was not stationary. You understand me? He was not stationary. He was going about, doing good, and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Two factors there. God anointed him. That to me I call the calling. You understand me? So it is possible as a man or a woman that the Lord will call you to start your own independent ministry, which is not a church. A non-church ministry is what I'm talking about. So when you see somebody has a ministry, everybody does not end up with church. You know, like this wonderful one of those telling me, I thought daddy has a church. I said, no, it's not a church ministry. It's possible that God will give you a ministry that is not a church ministry, a church-based ministry. Like if you're in the music ministry, you're in the drama ministry, or God has given you a men's ministry. I think we should begin to have men ministry. Have you, Pastor Isla?
Very good. Very true.
God should be raising them up. We should be having sons of destiny's coordinate. Okay. Men on a mission. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Man of God. Have you? We should be having men.
We should.
When ministry, we really need them so that the home will be balanced.
Very true.
Very, very important. So that we'll be having balanced ministry. So you can have a men ministry. You can have a women ministry. You understand me? You are welcome, please. So it is possible for you that God will give you a ministry that goes from one place to another. Not a church base, like our ministry. That's why I'm talking about that this morning. Our ministry is not a church ministry. And I don't have a vision of a church. I'm an evangelist who go about organizing programs, doing things, ministering in drama, ministering in music, all over the place. So it is possible that the Lord will call a man or a woman to run an independent ministry. So how do we do it effectively in Europe? Which means in this kind of ministry, you might not have members. You understand me? You might not have members because the vision is for you. It is to you directly that God has given unto you, you know, to do. And so they will now become your member, your children, your husband, your wife. All you just need is at least one person with yourself. Even if you don't have one person with yourself. When the Lord called me into the ministry, I was in school then. But I was part of a group before that were leading a group of teenagers. So immediately I started the ministry, I invited the other sisters to join. But after 2 weeks, they said no, that their vision is not to join an independent ministry. And with the whole of my heart, I released them. So I was left alone with this vision, you know, to run with it. So I began to pray. It is in the place of prayer that the Lord gave me ideas on how to go about it, which I'm going to be sharing some secrets with us in a few minutes. How to go about it. So you don't have anybody, you don't have people around you, that does not mean you cannot run a ministry. You're called to go from place to place doing good, which means you as a person, you will not have a church where you worship, just like our daddy, you understand me? So therefore, it is not every ministry that leads to a church. That is a mistake we always have here. Everybody open church, this one open church. That one, it's not a business you are opening now. And that's why we have so many strange ministers on the altar. You rock my shoe and get anointing, drop 50 euros. And anointing will come. You understand me? Because when you are not called, you begin to use genies to call, to, you know, to draw the people. When you are called by God, the one who called you will back you.
Yes.
I was just in school then. So after praying for several months, the Lord gave me an idea. He said, you have friends. I said, yes. Who are children of God? So I started calling them into the, you know, to join me anytime I want to go and minister in drama. Praise the Lord. So you don't have members. I didn't have members. Nobody. But then the Lord has given me the vision of a drama ministry. The Lord spoke about Daughters of Destiny right from that time. The Lord spoke about the magazine, about the book. The Lord told me about the international ministry right from 1996. So I wrote it down. The vision is for an appointed time. That the Lord spoke to you and it has not come to pass doesn't mean it's not coming to pass. It's going to come to pass. It's for an appointed time. And the appointed time will definitely come. So how do you now go about things? God has given you this vision. Number one thing is to understand the vision that God has given unto you. What are you called to do? Write it out. Are you called to lead women? Are you called to lead men? Eh? Men on a mission, sons of destiny. And men ministry must start. No, it must start.
Yes.
We should begin to have men ministry. And they will invite us for dinner too. Yes. And we'll just go with them.
Sons of Abraham.
Sons of Abraham. God bless you. Man of God should catch their division.
Yes. I catch it.
That is the thing. So get the vision. Or God can call you into a children ministry. Or a teenage ministry. The gathering teenagers together. Gathering children together. Or a music ministry. Write the vision down. What are the activities? Father, what are the areas? There are some areas that God will tell you about now, but it's not now that it will come to pass. It is for later. Write it down. Make it plain. You know, share with your husband. Share with your wife. The calling of God is not gender-based. In Joel 2:28, he said, for I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. I know some men have issues with women leading a ministry. You understand me? But the call of God is not for, you know, men only. Even for our children. As they are now, they are telling you, Mama, as your PA is telling you now, evangelist, this guy should begin to see vision.
Amen.
And she will tell you of what God wants her to do.
Amen.
You encourage her.
Amen.
How old was Samuel when he was just on the altar? And God called him. And he went to Hela to be guided by God. So God can be showing our children the things he has in mind for them. So right now, what are the activities? God has called you and given you an independent ministry. Don't go and attach yourself to the church. That is one of the errors that you can make. Have your own identity. Stand. Praise the Lord. Have your own identity. Are you alive? You are alive. Okay. Have your own identity that God has given unto you. What is the name? There is power in a name. He said, for I lay in Zion a tested soul. The Lord gave you Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. They said, they overcame it. He said, the name of the ministry is overcomers. And when the Lord, there is power in the name. When the Lord said there are overcome, you are an overcomer, it means there are battles you will fight. And you will overcome.
Hallelujah.
You understand me? There is power in the name. The problem in the life of some ministers today, why their ministry are not prospering, is in the name. What is the name that you are called? What is the name that you call the ministry? There is power in the name. Somebody is going to change his name after this program.
Amen.
Some ministry's name will change.
Amen.
So the name will speak for you. Amen. My name means the Lord is worthy to be praised. And so that is why you're always thanking God for my life.
Hallelujah.
Even me, I thank God for my life.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. What was to have a son and the Lord gave us the name Victor. Little did we understand that Latin means there is going to be battle. And he gave us victory. Write down the activities. Don't be quick in gathering people together. We make that mistake. You begin to gather your church member and put them in the ministry. There will be confusion. Have your own identity. Have your own identity. Not just merging people together. What has God called you to do? Understand it. Write it down. How do you go about it? Then the Lord give you wisdom. The wisdom God gave me then was to go and invite my friends who are children of God to join me on drama ministrations. Anytime I'm going for ministration. Now, as an independent ministry, nobody knows you. You understand me? You are only known by God. So you cannot sit down and say, God has called me into a music ministry. Then you are waiting for people to invite you. You invite yourself first. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God can give you a vision to begin to organize concerts. Worship evening. We don't have much of it here. Look at what the Lord did 2 days ago in the concert for those of us who are there. You just organize it and put things together. It does not mean that you will be the one to sing. The Bible says the apostles, they prefer one another. Nobody has monopoly of anointing. If you're a pastor, you're the only one preaching every Sunday. You're the only one doing something. It's an error. You replicate yourself. Yes, it's wrong. It's very, very wrong. You don't have it all. You must be able to produce yourself. Give other people opportunity. That is when you will know what they carry on the inside and you'll be able to carry them. Some pastors, they will preach only, they will not allow their wife. The ones you are not carrying along will cause problems for you, ministry. Yes. Be able to go at the same pace or at most drag along with you. By fire, by force. You drag them along with you. Praise the Lord. So you must be able to carry on with them. So as the Lord give you grace, you can begin to organize activities like that. Then you are a music minister, God has given you women ministry and everything like that. You can write to churches. I want to go and minister in drama. That's what we do then. The Lord sent me to Nigerian secondary school. So I will go, I will write letter to secondary school. So before you see God, give me a big platform now. I have called Nigeria. Going to do drama. You don't think of honorarium at this stage. Nobody will give you honorarium. Now you invite yourself. But God gives honorarium. One of the honorarium is that I'm in Europe today. This is one of my honorarium. For the Lord calling me and making me to be here. Praise the Lord. So this is the honorarium that the Lord has given unto us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Are you in ministry for money purpose? Why are you called? So independent ministry, the foundation you take is the foundation of sacrifice. You will organize program, nobody will support you. Okay, who will you write that? Say support us for program. Praise the Lord. You support yourself. All the little savings that I will turn everything. My mother became angry with me. She said, you don't have savings again. Everything ministry. I will do catering with business and do it. Financing it. Thinking of the finance, you think from yourself first. If you write letter to people, support us in ministry, you need 5,000 euros, they will give you 50 euros.
True.
That is the thing. So how will the vision be done? That means when we say independent ministry, means you are depending on God.
Hallelujah.
Tell me, Sister Joyce, man of God, sir, have God not been paying you back for those labor? So it is possible for you to have an independent ministry in you and run it. You don't need crowd. Me and my household, we will serve the Lord. You start with that household and start doing the work. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And from there, you understand me, the work begins to go on. So like I said, organize program. Ask for permission. We have a letter we used to write. Permission to come and minister in church. As you go from place to place, God will begin to make a name for himself.
Amen.
You understand me? He will begin to make a name for himself in that program. So as you go from one place to another, you're welcome, you can see. As you go from one place to another, God begin to make a name for himself.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God begin to make a name for himself. People begin to respond and gather. You understand me? You can come to the front. So independent ministry, you know, God has called you. You are the founder and the president of the ministry. Don't look at yourself as so the president and the founder of how many people? 2 people. 3 people, 4 people, you understand me? It is much more than that. Amen.
Amen.
God has called you much, much more than that. The Bible says, though your beginning may be small, but your later hand shall be great. That scripture we read, it says, Jesus went about doing good. So you are going about doing the work of God, not to go and break people or to break churches.
But as an independent ministry owner, you are going about either singing in churches, you're doing drama, you're organizing programs for women, for children, for teenagers, for men. Eh, sons of Abraham, men on a mission, sons of destiny.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Or the doctor's ministry, because we have some who are midwives. Praise the Lord.
Oh, yes.
Attending to the need of the soul. So it is scriptural. Because the Bible makes you to understand. Let's open in the book of Ephesians. Sister Eunice, it's my husband. Ephesians chapter 5. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sorry, I didn't write it down, so I had to look for it. All right. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7. I read, but unto everyone is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore he said, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gift unto man. You understand? And now that he ascended, what is it that he has also descended first into the lower part of the heart? He that descended, he is the same that has ascended. Amen. Verse 11 is where I'm going. And he gave some apostles, some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors, and some teachers. Some apostles. So some are just called apostles. Apostles, they go about, you know, also they also go around edifying churches, strengthening churches, you know, building people up. Praise the Lord, someone. They build people up, they strengthen churches, they, you know, they commission, they're like church planters, or giving support to pastors. You understand me now? Prophet, they prophesy. Thou says the Lord, that is their home. Thou says the Lord. You understand me?
Yes.
And the problem we have today is that some who are not supposed to be church owners, they begin to found a church. When the prophet now began to found a church, you understand me? Then how will the teaching of the word come in? Every Sunday, only prophecy will be hearing. Man shall not live by prophecy. Man, you understand me? So we need the word of God. And that is the problem we are having. Prophets are supposed to support pastors and evangelistic ministries. Praise the Lord. Then we have some who are teachers. They teach the word. A teacher can as well be a pastor. He can be an evangelist. Some function in this fivefold ministry, but you must know the one that the Lord has called you to be. Hallelujah, somebody. Mm-hmm. And then stick in the area that the Lord has apportioned for you, that the Lord has ordained for you, so that you'll be able to function effectively there. And then where I'm going to the evangelist. So when you go about doing good, you are in the ministry of an evangelist, doing your work in different places. You are not tied down to the church. Some that will be going down today have been tied down by church activities. The Lord will set you loose today.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So when you get the vision like that, you're writing down what are the activities, then starting out. I told you, invite yourself, contact, make contact. And you think less of money. Ministry is not about money. But God surely will. Time will not permit you to begin to share testimony. Okay, we are in this hub. Yesterday we saw, for those of us who are there, we saw what happened. And we're very sorry for the other people that we invited. We have to change the venue, you know, overnight. Not that we had the money somewhere. But when God comes, he will never put you to shame.
At all.
When God wants to put you to shame, God will rise up.
Hallelujah.
It will rise up on you.
Yes.
As we stood there yesterday, what we have in our pockets was not even half of what we need to pay. And somebody paid.
Amen.
I said, no. He said, relax. How much is the money? I said, even this money I'm putting down is meant for something else. He said, don't worry, sister. This program, now I understand why the devil is fighting.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me? So on the regular Sunday, it's not as if you are holding church and you are collecting offering. Okay, all the offering we have been giving, how much is it? Is it up to the food we are eating? All the programs that we have here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So when the Lord calls you, he back you up. You think less of finances. So as an independent ministry owner, you are out to do what? To evangelize. You are out to evangelize, to preach, to teach people. So like I said, the money will come first from your own pocket. From your own pocket, the money will come first, and you begin to do more. Even if the Lord has called you to start a church, initially it will be your finances. It's your calling. So then the Lord came with the idea. I started inviting my friend. But you know something? You are inviting them to go and minister with you. You know what I always do? When we are going for those outreaches to secondary school to go and stay drama back in Nigeria again, I will fast their fasting. Join me to my friend. Yes. Because you are responsible for those people that are taking along with you. The first ministration I went for, the transport was 1,000 something at that time. I have only 100 naira in my pocket. All my friends then, you know, we are born again spiritual. They were taller and older than me. And I was, don't look at this finished product you are seeing now. I was a very tiny little kid. But with a mighty God in this. Yeah. We got to the pastor. He said, "Tony, you did not tell us that you don't have money." I said, "God said we should do it." And today, just the way the Lord said it, he said, "This day to Moses, I will magnify you in front of the people. That day the Lord magnify me in front of my friends. They no longer see me as Tony. They see me as God's
servant." Ha, Pastor Talibos. Jesus.
I did not say, "Call me mama, call me papa." As an independent ministry
woman, Jesus.
Nobody need to lay hands on you to become an evangelist. You are already called to
thy God. Speak, mama.
Yes. And that is the ministry all of us have been called. Say, go into the world and preach the gospel. So God has given you a ministry to go and reach out to women. It's not based in the church. You understand me? You don't need a special title to do that. It is not about titles. It's about we go to Ogbomosho. It was Ogbomosho Southwest Nigeria with 100 men to go and minister before teenagers. As an independent ministry owner, you must go anywhere he said. Just like Daddy told us yesterday, when the rod is lifted, you must use the rod. It's not just like that. If God said, God told to Moses, he said, "Stretch forth the rod in your hand." You have to stretch your faith. It's a step of faith. People do extra. We are in ministry. It's how you people survive. You are not having a church. You are only working for God. I'm not a lazy woman working for God. This work I'm doing is a hard work.
Yes.
I was telling you, I said I slept only 2 hours throughout the year. Last night, now I slept 5 hours. My body comes out.
Hallelujah.
I want to finish the conference. I still very well. So you are working for the Lord, not for any man. At that time, you know, it's not like you are waiting. A pastor did not tell me thank you. Which pastor will tell you thank you? You are the owner of the world. You are the pastor that will encourage. Bible says, David encouraged himself in the Lord. You will encourage yourself in the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To keep on doing the work, to bring the money from your everything you have, you use it for the gospel. As a young girl, as a young lady, you know, at that age, you want to buy this one, you want to buy that one. Even I was buying ministry. And today, God is buying all those things for you.
Hallelujah.
So you will learn to put in your resources into the work. At that time, I was a worker in the church. You understand me? But when the ministry got to a level, I pulled out from being a worker. You must know where your priority lies. And that's another place where we have problems today. You are the head of the choir. You are the head of the hostel. And yet, God has given you an international ministry. This weekend, you are not in church. That weekend, you will have problems with pastor. Even if I'm your pastor, you will have problems with me. Because the Bible says you should not do the work of God with slackness. You must be able to identify what has the Lord called you to do. God has called you to ministry. In ministry, there is service unto God. But in service, there is no ministry. So I choose to be in the ministry to fulfill my purpose. So that you see me sit down in church, I don't know whatever, and I'm not doing anything in church. That doesn't mean I'm lazy. Or I'm not working for the Lord. What I'm doing is much more than that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that is how the Lord helped us. Help me to start the work. I'll be praying, teaching the people, going for drama and everything. And you know, they are teenagers, children. Nobody will give you an honorarium. But do you know something? That particular day, God went ahead. I went to the student fellowship, because you know, in Boarding House, we always have student fellowship. I wrote to them. God put it in their hand. They put it in their hand. In the end of the day, there was a brother I knew back from Ibadan. That day, he just came back home. The exact money we needed to be completed was in his hand. He just gave us. When we were going back, my friend that went with me as my friend, they looked back at me. They couldn't look at me as a friend again.
Wow.
They saw God. They said, "This woman is a woman of faith." So to run an effective independent ministry in Europe, you need faith. Somebody might say, "Well, that one is in Nigeria. You have people around you." So I got married. The Lord relocated me to Europe. My husband was not in drama ministry. That had nothing to do with film production or anything. The only thing is that he was an ardent fan, always watching our movies. And so we came here. You understand? Living members. You know, over the year, the Lord gave us members and everything. The work was well structured. Well done. But the Lord now brought us here. So what now happened? My husband became my number one student.
He told me, look at me, teach me. How do we go about this work?
To do this work. Sabitri, put it in this side. Apart. So you give us this work to do. So we came to Hero. You, me. Me, you. Abi? Solo this. I'm learning Spanish. Praise the Lord. How do we not get the work done? So we told ourselves, we begin to pray. God will have brought us to a continent. The same approach, we now started writing churches. We want to come and show the film in your church. Give us permission to come and show drama and everything. So we started using our money. I did not say I've been in ministry for 14 and a half years. By that time, the ministry was already established and known internationally in Nigeria. All being from Nigeria, all over. By the time I relocated, I went with my husband to the church conference. And people were walking up to me and saying, my God, God bless you. How have you been blessed by me? What are you doing here? You just visit. I said, no, I live there now. They look at you like a woman that is crazy. How can you leave everything God is doing? But it is promotion. So as an independent ministry owner, you must know when the Lord wants you to move. You move when he wants you to move. Good sentiment. Before my husband came along, the Lord told me you are having an international ministry. In fact, the word came out almost 7 or 8 years before my husband came. That ministry has not started. That when you get married, you leave Nigeria. That is when your ministry begins. For all the years of 14 and a half years in ministry, the Lord said, that's not started. It was preparation. For the main thing that the Lord has in mind to do. So we came to Hero. So it was me, you, me. My husband doesn't know how to say drama. So the first movie we shot when we came here, Living for Tomorrow, and I edited it into three different parts. You know, it's like, not like Nigeria. Most services here, 2 hours. In fact, in Spain here, we are trying. In Netherlands, 2 hours, service is over. So we have to put the drama little by little. So for 15 minutes, then we'll go there and show the drama. Then one day I said to my husband, I said, we can do stage drama now. He said, but we are only two. And the Lord began to give me messages for two people. How many people have seen us minister? Oh, I wish we prepared for one. Only two of us, and you have been blessed. Let me see your hand. Two people only. And the word come alive. We put some of our on our YouTube channel. At that time, in Nigeria, I want to shoot a movie. You have about 16 people behind the camera. Now, how do you get the work? The first time, it was only me and my husband. So we learn how to share the work. So don't wait for people. Don't wait for people until the people come. The work in this place. So we started doing it all alone, doing it together, and you know, staging drama. Most times, it's inside the train as we are going for ministration, we'll be rehearsing. And you say, this is how to say it, you know, and like that. That is how the work began. To organize programs. So what we used to do with 16 people, the Lord began to help us to do it with how many people? Only two of us. So you have every limitation that you have as an independent ministry owner, you turn it into, you know, a step further.
Amen.
Then we now begin to work with people, you know, and you have to be careful and prayerful the kind of people you involve in the work. You understand me? And begin to call them to help us to do one or two things. Oh, you can help us with this one. We invite people. Then in Nigeria, before when we shoot movie, we will put like 20, 30 people. But here we now begin to understand. 3 people, 4 people can have to stay.
Yes.
And the messages are still coming out. So at this stage, you must understand how God wants you to go about it. Then now, it will not take me to the next word I want to talk about, relationship and association. You understand me? Look for people of like mind. People that Bible says can even spirit you say can two work together, except they agree.
Oh, yes.
Who are the people that you are working with? Are they people of the same mind? Are they people of the same spirit with you? Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. So just if I just be another family that God will just link you together and you are doing the work as an independent ministry. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I think God has given you a music ministry. In fact, you don't need backup. You record one song, do backup for yourself and go and do the work. Let nothing stop you from the work. Let nothing stop you from this work that the Lord has given unto you. So you now look for people who have the same mind, people who have the same spirit, that you can work together. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that is how we started, you know, rehearsing with people. And when it comes to the time of organizing programs, you understand me? We have the internet. I wish I could have time to talk about it because I realize here is many of us are not on social media. Yes, some of social media is bad, they are sharing whatever, but you can also use it for the gospel. Just like that, encouraged us yesterday. That when you have 12,000 followers on Facebook, you have 12,000 congregation. So now begin to use the social media. And people say, oh, you're not in Europe. Oh, you're in Netherlands. That way, connection, people who have been blessed by what you do. And another thing is that the sacrifice doesn't end there. Then the Lord begins to say, begin to feed my children with movies. We started uploading freely on YouTube for people to be blessed. I said, so where will the resources come? Those who are blessed by the ministry, they will show sleep into you. Yeah. God will take sleep away from some people's eyes because it is time for the Lord. Just like we had yesterday, that the extra and part of the extra is what we are having today. This is part of the extra. Yes, the extra came. Because when you are diligent in what the Lord has committed to your hand, He will promote you. He will stand before kings, not you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Help on this note. So I will go on another one. But I believe God has dropped one word or two to our heart. You don't need structure. You don't need to gather the crowd. You understand? You start from the assignment. The hands are working with people of the same mind. When you're going to go close to anybody in ministry, do you believe in the same thing? Do you believe in the ministry of that person? Do you believe in what he or she is teaching? The Lord will help us in Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know whether we have any question. One question or two. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yeah. As you were talking about, you mentioned somewhere and God lost the self-service is different from ministry.
Yes. What I mean is that when you are a worker in the church, it's service unto the Lord. God has called you into a ministry. The ministry of reaching out to women is a different thing. Though in that way you are also serving God. You understand me? But your giving is bigger than just being a worker in the church. Because this is not your assignment. You know, as I'm talking about an independent ministry, you can also be a member of the church, but you have a bigger assignment, a bigger ministry. And in that ministry, you are also serving. Let's stand up on our feet as we begin to pray.